ओके स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस कंसेप्ट ऑफ इम्प्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ स्टार स्कीमा इन एसक्यूएल सर्वर यूजिंग SSIS. फर्स्ट वी विल क्रिएट द स्टार स्कीमा एंड देन वी विल लोड द डेटा फ्रॉम सोर्स डेटाबेस टू आवर डेस्टिनेशन और स्टार स्कीमा यूजिंग द SSIS. वी सी डेट वी आर हैविंग द सोर्स डेटाबेस डेट इज़ द एडवेंचर वर्क 2019. फ्राम एडवेंचर वर्क 2019 वी हैव टू टेक द डेटा, क्रिएट द डिफरेंट डायमेंशन टेबल एंड फैक्ट टेबल. एज स्टार स्कीमा कंसिस्ट ऑफ द टू डिफरेंट टेबल, वन इज द डायमेंशन टेबल एंड द फैक्ट टेबल. अकॉर्डिंग टू द डेफिनेशन ऑफ स्टार स्कीमा, फैक्ट टेबल इज एट द मिडल वाइल डायमेंशन टेबल आर अराउंड द फैक्ट टेबल एंड डायमेंशन टेबल आर डायरेक्टली कनेक्टेड विद द फैक्ट टेबल. सो वेन एवर वी हैव अ डेटा अवेलेबल इन द डायमेंशन टेबल आर इन एनी सोर्स लाइक एडवेंचर वर्क 2019, so we have to take the data from adventure work 2019 and then move it to the our star schema. The name of our star schema will be sales db. Very first step, we have to create the database and then use database. Create database, name of database, and then use database, same database, click go. Now after this one, when this one is created, so it's mean all the new table will be moved to the newly created database. How we can create it or what we can do? So for this one, we see that we are having in the source database different table are available. Little I have descriptions related to those source table. Like first one, we are having the in source customer dimension is available and geography dimension is available. We have to take the data from the customer dimension table that is available over here in Adventure Work 2019, having the different attribute. We will take few attribute from here, right? From the customer dimension, like those attribute can be customer key, first name, last names, or we can take it over here full names, then birth date, marital status, gender, email, and others. Like those attribute list is here that we want to take it. So we are having, we would like to take the attribute customer DW key, that will be the surrogate key that is not available in our database. We want to create it automatically using the concept of identity. Second one is the customer key, that value is available in the source table. Full name in source, we don't have the full name in source table. Customer source table, we are having the first name and last name. We have to use one transformation in SSIS. Using that transformation, derived column transformation, we may be able to transform first name and last name value into the full names. Then email address, birth date, marital status, gender, education, all of these columns are available in the source. And occupation, for education and occupation at source table, we are having the English education and English occupations. Similarly for city, state, province and country region, all of these columns we are having the data is available in the geography table. So we have to create the join between customer dimension table as well as geography dimension table. To create the join in SSIS, we have to use the concept of merge join, and in merge join we have to select the inner join, and then we have age column value will be taken from the birth date. Mean we have to use the one column that is the dat diff columns. Dat diff column will help us to calculate the value of age and year, right? So we have to apply it over here, the case functions or case statement. Using the case statement, it will calculate that when age differences in case statement, we have to use the dat diff functions. Dat diff function, when the difference is less than 40, so that person is considered as a younger. When dat difference is age difference is greater than 50, mean current timestamps and birth date differences, they are 50 years, that person is considered as the older. Otherwise age is considered as a label as considered as a middle age. And similarly, current flag, data type of that one will be bit, and that will be considered as a default value, will be considered as a 1. That is the way that in this way we may be able to create age as case. When dat diff in the form of year, we can calculate dat difference in the year, month or day, DD, MM, anyone we can use it over here, right? So dat diff, years and birth date, current timestamps. Current timestamp will calculate what is the current date and the difference between the birth date. We have to calculate it in the form of years, right? If that is less than 40, then younger. if greater than 50, older, otherwise middle age. Age value will be calculated. That is for the customer dimension table. How we can calculate it? For that one, we are having the customer dimension table is there. I already have a code. So we select customer key, customer DW key, data type is integer, and I want to use it over here as identity. And for identity, I want to use it here 1, 1. Mean initial value will be started from 1 and last value will be 1. Then we are having the customer key, full name. I am not using here first name and last name. I am using it over here full name. At the time of using the SSIS package, we have to use the derived column and then transform first name and last name value into the full name. Then email address, birth date, marital status, gender, education, occupations. All of these columns belong to the customer dimension table, while city, state, province and country region belong to the geography dimension table. And next one, we have age. We have to calculate the value of age. And then current flag, that is used as a flag. What is the current status of the customers? That is customers is present or not. So default value, that is a 1 for all customers. At initially we will consider as a 1. And then we assign the primary key. Let me execute this one for the customer dimension table. So it say that sales in sales DB one table is created. That is the customer dimension table. Second one, we have a product dimension table. In product dimension table, we have to take data from the three different table. First one, we are having the product dimension table. Just check it out. In product dimension table, we have a few columns like product key, product names, color and size. All of these columns are available in the product dimension table. Product key, product names, color and size. So these column values are available in the product dimension table, while subcategory name is available in the subcategory table and category name value is available in the category table. And then we have to assign the primary key, that is the product key. Next one, dates dimension table. We are having the date key. Then we have a column full date, month number, calendar quarter and calendar year. Primary key, we see that is a dead key is a primary key. Let me recreate the product dimension. So product dimension is created. Next one, we have a dead dimension. We have to create now for dead dimension, we have to take data from only one dimension table, and that is the dimension dead dimension table. Last one, we have a internet sale. In internet sale, that is will be considered as a fact table. So what we have to do? We have internet sale key, customer DW key. These are the primary key of the fact dimension table, customers dimension table. This one is considered as a product key, is considered as a primary key of the product dimension table. Date key is considered as a primary key of date dimension table. While here all of these are customer DW key, product key and date key. All of these are considered as a fire on key. Next one, order quantity, that is the numeric attributes. We must have to use the numeric attribute in a fact table, right? So here I am using the internet sale key, that is the surrogate key that is used for unique identification of the record, or we say that concatenated fact table key. Sale amount, unit price, discount amount, all of these are considered as a numeric attribute. These all of these four are considered as a numeric attribute that is used for the measurement, that is used for the calculation. And we say that primary key is here, that we are having internet sale key is a primary key. Execute it. Now this one is fact table is also created. Now we have to use the assign the foreign key. So what are the different foreign key? We say that customer DW key is one foreign key. Alter table, name of table, add constraint, name of constraint, foreign key, and then reference table. Customer dimension table is one foreign key. Another foreign key, we say that's a alter table, name of table, internet sales, add constraints, produce the foreign key, and then product key is considered as a foreign key over here. Two different foreign keys are assigned, and last one, we are having the dead key. Just check it out. Now third one foreign key as a sign. So here we create the three different dimension table and one fact table. Our schema name is here sales DB. Let's see that that one schema is created or not. Just refresh it with the name of sales DB and just check it out, the diagrams of the sales DB. We can check it over here. List of the table will be here. We will have the three table. Customer, three dimension table. One is customer, second one is date, and third one is a product, while one fact table, that is the internet sale. If we want to check the diagrams, right click and new diagram. Yes. Then we have to add all of those table over here in the diagrams. Let's see. Add it. Select all and then click on add. So that will be added over here and it create a diagram over here for the star schema. In star schema, I am again repeating, the fact table is at the middle and dimension table are around the fact table. And dimension table are directly connected with the fact table. Close it. So here we can see that we are having fact table, internet sale is at the middle, while customer is a dimension table, product is another dimension table, and we have a date is another dimension table. So three different dimension table are there. So fact table is at the middle, internet sale, while dimension table are around the fact table, product, customers, and dimension. And dimension table are directly connected with the fact table. That is the process for creation of the star schema. Next, we will discuss how we may be able to move the data from AdventureWorks DW 2019 to these schema. If you people have any question, then may I ask, please.